Patients who have coronary chronic total occlusions have a very aggressive form of coronary artery disease. So having a CTO, chronic total occlusion, itself is a challenge. And PCI for these patients involves, number one, two access points so that we can visualize the blood vessel, the anatomy of the blood vessel, and understand it properly. And that can be challenging. And all you have challenges in almost every step of the way. I think the overall biggest challenge is convincing the cardiology community that just because you have a chronic total occlusion does not mean you just have to end up with medical therapy. If they are appropriate candidates, that is, if they have viable myocardium, they are refractory to medical therapy, CT or PCI should be offered to them. I think just getting that point across can be difficult and is probably the biggest challenge. Education, education, education. So you need to educate yourself in the CTO PCI skill set. Number two, you need to educate your cardiology community about the risks and benefits of CTO PCI. Number three, you need to educate the community in general that there is an option available for patients who have such a disease process. So that will be step number one, which kind of involves three steps. Step number two is, once you've mastered or at least attended educational programs, is to create your own patient database of patients who have chronic total occlusions, who have failed medical therapy or have refractory symptoms, and then offer CTO PCI to them. That will be step number two. Then getting adequate proctors to come and help you master the skill set. CTO PCI is an evolving thing. Okay, it's not that you go for one course and you're done and you've mastered it. With each case, each procedure, you learn more, so the education never stops. So keeping your eyes and mind open to that is very important. So educating yourself, educating your community of physicians and population, and then getting yourself good proctors and proctor-mediated education is the key to a successful CTO program. And the second part of the question is, what can an interventional cardiologist get? Number one, very extremely grateful patients. These are a patient population who have been told, there's nothing else I can do for you. You just have to be on medicine. Just learn to live with your life. Just walk slower. Just walk less, do less, be small, accept a smaller life. And when you actually do the procedure for them and they suddenly realize the chains that were binding them is gone, they are just so ecstatic and so thankful. And it's kind of a very humbling gratitude kind of a moment for yourself, but grateful patients is what you get. Number two will be, you as an interventional cardiologist, your skill set just takes the next level. You might be doing complex PCI before CTO PCI, but once you've managed to go through the steps or the motions of learning CTO PCI skill set, your hands are just different. Your brain is different. You just learn to solve, find a solution for every problem you face.